Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular Zero to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about how we can install Angular and create our first Angular application. In this video, I'm going to explain you how an Angular app works. Before we see how an Angular app works, let us first see about the files created by Angular CLI. Also, we need an IDE to start working on Angular. There are few good IDEs like VS Code, WebStorm, etc. I actually use VS Code, which is free. You can download VS Code from its official website, code.visualstudio.com. Let me open the first app we created in VS Code. First, we have E2E folder, which is for end-to-end testing. We will not touch anything in this folder if we don't have plans to test the application using this framework. Then we have node modules folder. This is the place where we have all the dependencies installed. If you delete this folder by mistake or on purpose, you can recreate it using the command npm install. Then we have src, our source folder. And this is the place where we have our application files, and this is where we play around. Then we have browser list rc. This file is used by the build system to adjust CSS and JavaScript output to support the browsers mentioned here. We will not change anything in this file. And we have editor config. Using this file, we can actually change the character set, intent size, code type, etc. But usually we will not change anything here also. Then we have gitignore. So whatever files or folders we listed out here will be ignored by the git. And we have angular.json. This is an important file. We change sometimes to add any external CSS or JavaScript or any other assets. For example, if you are adding Bootstrap CSS framework to your application, you need to add the path of the Bootstrap CSS from node modules folder in the styles array. And we have karma config file, which is also for testing, and we will not change this in most of our applications. Then we have package log.json and package.json. When we do npm install, npm use these files to install the dependencies. In package.json, we can see the dependencies. When you install an external library through npm, package.json will be updated and the install library will be added into dependencies object in package.json. And package log.json will be automatically created for any operations where npm modifies the node modules or package.json. So that when we do another npm install, we'll get the exact node modules tree. Then we have readme file, which we can modify related to our application. And we have tsconfig, which is TypeScript config. The first one is our application specific, and the second one is workspace specific. And the spec file is related to testing framework. We will not modify these files in general. Finally, we have the tslint.json in which we can see the linting rules for TypeScript. We will not modify this also. So in general, we mostly modify all the files inside source folder and then angular.json and package.json files. If I expand the source folder, I can see the app folder where I can see our application code like CSS, HTML, spec file, component file, and the module. App folder is also called root folder. If we create a new component, that will also get stored inside the root folder. And we have assets folder, in which we can store our assets like images, fonts, etc. And we have environments folder. Inside that, we can see environment files for both dev and production. Then we have a fav icon, an index.html, main.ts, which is the starting point of our application. And then we have polyfills, which we use to add browser support if needed. And we have styles.css, where we can keep our global styles. And the last one is test.ts, which is for testing. These are all the files generated by Angular CLI. Now we shall see how an Angular application is getting started. When I start our application using ng-serve and open it in browser, we can see this page by default. Actually, this is coming from the app component HTML. If I delete all these contents and use another HTML code, and if I save this, we can see the page is showing our new content. But how do Angular knows that it needs to show this content? What is happening when we use ngserve? Let's see that. Actually, we can also use npm start instead of ngserve, because in package.json, we can see the start command is ngserve. So when we use npm start or ngserve, the development server is started and it serves the index.html. We can verify this. If we view the source code, we can see only the index.html related code with some JavaScript injected by Angular. And what is this app root? How it gets transformed into this content? Actually, when the server is started, it will be looking for the entry point in the angular.json, which is nothing but the main. Here, the CLI has pointed the main.ts file in the source folder. So if you open the main.ts file, I can see the app module, which is getting bootstrapped. App module is also called root module. Every Angular application will have a root module, and that will be the first module which gets loaded when application is started. And if I open the app module, I can see the app component, which is our root component, is the one which is getting bootstrapped. And if I open the app component, I can see the selector is app-root. This is what we are using in the index.html. So Angular dynamically replaced this with whatever present in the app component. And in app component, we are instructing Angular to use the app component HTML template. That is why we are seeing this content in the browser. This is how an Angular application works. With this, we have completed the basics in Angular. Next, we shall dive into components, which is the building block of an Angular application. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button, and stay tuned. Thank you.